So the movie is Do You Believe? Can you tell me a little bit about your characters and what about the script spoke to you?
Well, I was very moved by the script. And I thought when my manager said to me, I thought she was saying face-based movie. And I said, what's a face-based movie?
Hey, you'd be great for that too, by the way.
But no, it's a faith-based movie, but it didn't matter. What mattered was the message of hope from this movie and the fact that these people actually go out of their way to help each other. And I just thought it was an excellent project. I'm really happy I did it.
It's great as an actor to read a script and see there's like four parts that you would fight for.
That's right.
You know, that's pretty cool. And mm-hmm. So I was very attracted to playing the pastor because he starts the movie and he wraps it up at the end and has a great arc throughout the story. So that's what you're always looking for, those moments.
Yeah.
And you know, by the way, you're not going to get cut.
Yeah. Doing anything that involves religion or politics in Hollywood can be risky.
Yeah.
You guys, at a point in your career, you're just like, I don't care. I think this is a great project. I'm going to do it. Or is there other motives behind it?
No, actually, I've been very active in politics,
yeah.
Pro-choice, and also women's right to choose. That's the same thing. But yeah, marched in Washington 3 times. And I have to say, leading a march, also for gay and lesbian rights, is a very powerful thing to do. You actually are risking your life. You're leading a group of people that can come close to 850,000 people, and
yeah.
It's very empowering.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think that in Hollywood, to stand up and make a stand, one
mm-hmm.
way or the other, it is risky. And you know, all Hollywood, it's much easier if they say, oh, you're in that box, you're with them, and you're in this box. And today, more than ever, you're seeing people able to sort of move between their boxes. But so, yeah, I do think it's risky. And I am at an age where, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah.
And that's all right with me.
Yeah.
I don't really care.
And then you grew up in the South, and mm-hmm. you actually considered the priesthood at one point, I believe, right?
Yeah.
Is there anything that you can remember that really tested your faith or reaffirmed it?
I definitely tested my father's faith.
Yeah.
That way. I'm a bad girl, but that was okay, too. I'm now a good girl, so you don't have to be afraid.
I think without going into detail, that for sure there are moments in my life where my faith has been tested. You know, a lot of times you just wonder, really?
Yeah.
Are you there?
Hmm.
Because I'm here, and this hurts, and I'm alone. And so there are those moments that you're tested.
Yeah.
But that's the journey.
Yeah, and then is there the reaffirming. Is there things that you're seeing in society today that reaffirms, you know, what you believe?
I have two young boys. I see it every day.
Yeah.
Every day. I look at them, I look at their friends, and I see magic, and I see belief in the future, and I do see faith. And I think that, you know, if all of us, if you just look, if you just really open your eyes, it is there. You just have to stand back and not be so judgmental, so negative, and you can find it. It is there. And
I remember when I knew I was going to have twins, that I went in for a test, and they could only find one heartbeat. And that period of time seemed very long. And then they found the other. So that was one of those moments for me.
Mm.
That's incredible. Like, when you're having that moment. Yeah, for sure. And then, you know, on a lighter note, I've heard rumors that there might be like a Married with Children reunion at some point.
Oh.
And what about a Moonlighting reunion? I would like to see both of those.
I'd love to see Moonlighting reunion. But
yeah, that would be fun.
The guy that created it doesn't see a way to do it. I'm sure Bruce would do it for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think with Married, I know that they were talking about David Faustino, who played Bud, called me and said that, you know, he's trying to do a pilot. Would we come and be in it if asked? And we all said, yes, we would.
Yeah.
So that was kind of the spin of a reunion. It was based sort of around his thing. But, you know, yeah, we would, I mean, certainly I would do it. It was fun. It was a great, great gig.